And hello again, everybody. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin here in the booth. And Chuck, you take a look at this matchup. I don't know if it's going to be one in the trenches from the quarterbacks out, whatever. It's going to be a good game.
Oh, without a doubt. I can't wait to see the big fellas have an impact. We're always spotlighting those wide receivers and quarterbacks and running backs and even the defensive backs. But the big guys, I can't wait to see which one tilts the balance for their team.
Here's the punter, Sam Martin, now ready to get us started. And we are underway in Foxborough. Set to return. This is Brandon Cooks. And look out, a big hit to the shoulder pads took him right off his feet at the 24-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down. His throw incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. They came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Time running out here on the play clock. They'll run for the first time with Mark Ingram. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. He's able to rattle off six on the carry, and that'll get him to third and four.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really shred your defense.
And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. So it'll be first down here after the run. Here's Ryan. He rifles one that's intercepted. He's picked off at his own 46. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. How about the big boys snagging one? You don't see that every week.
No, you don't, but a lot of them are just reliving their old dreams, going back to when they were in youth football and in high school. They didn't always play defensive line. Some of them actually handled the football, and you can see the flashback when he grabbed that one.
And he'll be knocked down sideways. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. See if they stay on the ground for second down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. On second down, Cook. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. At 5 yards on the play there, as the drive will continue.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. It's almost a tendency breaker.
And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
A 1 yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
This will be caught at about the 5. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now a run with Cook, and this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That'll set them back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down. And Sturgis able to knock it through. And the Chargers grab themselves a 3-0 lead. So the opening drive for them here on their home turf results in a field goal.
Now that's the way you want to get things started. Your stadium, your crowd, you've got the ball. Put points on the board first and let everyone start to celebrate.
This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So the Patriots coming out now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
To the right side, and he's got Landry complete. A good pickup there of 22.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is, because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll make it a second down. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. So the offense looking at a second and 8. Throwing again, Ryan. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Ingram. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, a big hit at the 36. Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4 for 4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when, who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row, I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down. Here's Ryan. Ball to the middle here to Wilson. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. A gain of 4 on the play. And on 4th down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. They'll throw on 1st down with Ryan. Throw left side complete. That's Ingram. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another 1st down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
From the red zone now, here's Ryan on 1st down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. 2nd and 10 now, Ryan. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. This drive, which was going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with 2 straight incompletions.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying, no more. We're making a stand right here, right now. But it is 3rd and 10. They've got to get after him one more time.
On 3rd down, Ryan. Being chased out left. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now 4th down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a 1st down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and that will tie us at 3-3. 1:59 to go in the first half. Back to 5.